Welcome back to ajspeller.com. In today's tutorial, we're going to work with a related rates problem. Here we have a 13-foot ladder is leaning against a wall. The bottom of the ladder slides away from the wall at a half a foot per second. How fast is the top of the ladder sliding down the wall when the foot of the ladder is 5 feet from the wall? We begin these related rates problems by making a simple sketch. We're going to start off by drawing the wall. Then I'm going to draw the ground. All right, put the ground in here. And then I want to draw the ladder that's leaning against the wall. Notice that we've created a right triangle. And what we're going to do is we're going to relate the proper formula with this right triangle. But first, let's go ahead and put in some of the missing pieces. Well, we said that this here is the ladder. We see here that the ladder is 13 feet, so we're going to add the 13 feet to this side here. The bottom here, the ground, I'm going to call that X. And this here is going to be the bottom of the ladder. And the vertical side here, I'm going to call this Y. And this here is going to be the top portion of the ladder. From the problem, we know that the bottom of this ladder is sliding away from the wall. So we know it's moving in this direction. And we know that that's symbolizing the change in x, and we're going to write that using the terminology dx dt, which is the change in x over time. And we see from the question here that the change in x over time is a half a foot per second. So here the fraction is going to be 1/2 feet in my numerator and then seconds in my denominator. And then we need to figure out how fast the top of the ladder is sliding down the wall. Well, this here is the top of the ladder, and here if we're sliding down the wall, we're sliding down the wall in this direction. We know that this here is going to be symbolized by dy dt, and we don't know what dy dt is at this particular moment. And the next thing that they're saying is they want to know when this bottom portion of the ladder is 5 feet away from the wall. So when that's 5 foot from the wall, well, we know this distance here, x, represents that. So we want to figure out where x, or when x is equal to 5. All right, but now let's think about the formulas we can relate to a right triangle. We could use the Pythagorean theorem, which is x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. In this case, we see that r is 13, so we can write 13 squared. Another formula we could use would be the area formula for a triangle, which would be area is equal to 1/2 the base. In this case, the base is x times the height. In this case, the height is y. And two more formulas we could use if we were dealing with our trig functions, where we could say x is equal to r cosine theta, where r is 13. So that'd be x is equal to 13 cosine theta. Or we could say where y is equal to r sine theta, again, where r is 13. All right, now we need to figure out which of these, or if any of these formulas here relate back to what we're doing in this particular problem. This problem is not asking anything about area, so we can discard the area formula. It also isn't asking anything about any of these angles in the right triangle. So that means we can also discard both of these. So we're left with the Pythagorean theorem. All right, so we're going to get back to that because we're going to use implicit differentiation on that. But before we get to that, we need to set up what I'm going to call a snapshot. All right, with this snapshot, we need to figure out what's going on with this triangle when the x value is set at 5. So basically, when the bottom of this ladder is 5 feet from the wall. So to do that, we're going to create another drawing. All right, so here we're going to start with another right triangle. Again, that's the wall. Well, this is the wall, that's the ground, and this here is the ladder. All right, we're saying that x is equal to 5. So we're worried about when we're 5 feet from the wall here. We know the length of the ladder is not going to change. So the ladder is still at 13 feet. We need to figure out what the y value is going to be at that moment in time. Well, to figure out this length, we have to use the Pythagorean theorem. So what we're going to do here is we're going to write y squared plus x squared. Well, x is 5, so x squared is going to be 25, is equal to r squared, where r is 13, and 13 squared is 169. So this here is our equation. We need to subtract 25 from both sides as we begin to solve for y. So we end up with 169 minus 25. All right, 169 minus 25 leaves us with 144, and we bring down our y squared. But we don't want y squared, we want y. So we take the square root of both sides. So here we see that y turns out to be 12 feet. So we're going to write that right here. And we're going to use these values later after we do our differentiation. Alright, so let's go ahead now and do the implicit differentiation of this equation here with respect to time. So we're going to take the derivative of x squared, which gives us 2x. Because we're taking the derivative with respect to time, we need to tack on the factor or the differential dx dt plus we need to take the derivative of y squared, which gives us 2y. Again, we're taking the derivative with respect to t, so we have to tack on the factor dy dt. And lastly, we have a constant, and when you take the derivative of a constant, that value comes out to be 0. Now notice we have several variables here. We have x, we have dx dt, we have y, and we have dy dt. We have values for x, which is 5 feet, dx dt, which is half a foot per second. Value for y, we just figured out to be 12 foot, and we're going to figure out what dy dt is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to make those substitutions. All right, so we're going to write our, let's scroll up a little bit. We're going to write our 2 right here. We said that x was 5 feet, so we're going to place in 5 feet. Notice I'm placing the units in here. Dx dt we said was 1/2, so I'm going to start with the 1/2, and then I'm going to tack on the units, which were feet per second, plus 2 times y. We just figured out that y is 12 feet. And then we have dy dt, or the change in y over time, which is what we don't know. And all that's set equal to 0. And now we're going to begin to simplify what we have here. Well, I have a 2 in my numerator and a 2 in my denominator, so they can cancel. And now I'll begin to multiply. 5 times 1 to give me 5. Feet times feet to give me feet squared. And then I have seconds times 1 to just give me seconds. Plus 2 times 12 to give me 24. And then I put on my units, which are feet, and then I write in my dy dt and equals 0. All right, I still need to solve this for dy dt, so I'm going to subtract this term from both sides. So I end up with 24 feet dy dt is equal to negative, because I'm subtracting this entire term, so negative 5 square feet per second. And now I need to get this dy dt by itself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal of 24 feet. It's understood that 24 feet is over 1. So I'm going to multiply by the reciprocal, which is going to be 1 over 24 feet. And what that does is that causes these units here to cancel with these units here. So I'm left with the dy dt. But remember, whatever you do to one side of an equation, you have to do to the other side. So here, I'm going to multiply again by this reciprocal, which is 1 over 24 feet. And now I see that I can do a little bit of canceling. I have feet down here and feet squared up here. So the feet here cancel, and this here turns from feet squared to just feet. And now I can just do my multiplication. I have 1 times negative 5 feet, so I just have negative 5 feet. And then for my denominator, I have 24 times seconds to give me 24 seconds. So here I see that the change in y at the moment that the x value is 5 feet is negative 5/24 feet per second. So this here solves what we're looking for this particular problem. All right, we went through a lot here, but we're going to call this a video. In a later video, I'm going to actually show how we can use technology to help verify our answer. Thank you for watching another video by ajspeller.com, and as always, have a good day.